Welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and also on YouTube if you're watching this video later on over there. For our next deck, which is going to be Mono Red Krasis. You may remember us playing this deck yesterday, and it was pretty impressive. I liked the deck quite a bit. Mana did not seem too difficult, and everything. Basically, what we're doing here is we're basically like the Jund Chain Whirler deck. You know how you've seen like the Chain Whirler deck with it splashes for status statue for the Chain Whirler combo? We're similar to that, but instead of splashing for Chain Whirler combo, we're splashing for Hydroid Krasis, basically. Yeah, we do not have any negates. We have like one negate here, expansion. You know, we copy our opponent's negate. That's our negate over there. But yeah, the deck played pretty well yesterday, and a lot of people liked it here in chat and everything, and it got some good positive vibes from the deck, so going ahead and running it back right away and trying it again. So let's go ahead and play some Mono Red Krasis. What? One of the cards went away? I don't know, just whatever. Discard the changes. Whatever card went away, bring it back. Play first. That's a reasonable hand. Got some early removal while we set up and build towards this Karn. Yeah, okay. Alright, so they are likely not going to have any kind of instants or sorceries for me to get with the Daredevil, so just playing that immediately. See if we find like a Chain Whirler. Ugh. There we go. All right, figured that out. Why is our opponent suddenly attacking there? What was that attack about? Oh, unbreakable formation? Crap. Well, that's my bad.
Good choice.
Multitasking. All right, I was making the... making the YouTube thumbnail for our last deck, the Simic Midrange. Yeah, that'd be nice to have that Daredevil still. Have 5 power of first strike blockers. So they still need 2 more permanents to ascend.
You are acting unwisely. fake reveal who we are.
So good news, they're just down to one card. Come on, don't, no permanent. Dang it. All right, so they have ascended. Which I guess that's really not that big a deal. We still just block old Snubby. I'm surprised they didn't choose Snubbers, because this is obviously that I need to block the Snubby, because so then that keeps Karn alive. Surprised the bodyguard wasn't the bodyguard saving the aspirant. I guess in case of Chain Whirler. Yeah, I didn't like that Daredevil anyway.
How convenient. An excellent choice.
And next turn we'll have Krasis for 6. We can draw 3. Yeah, Karn has done a really good job filtering all them lands out. We didn't even get to show you the cool part of our deck. So, Cannonades, War Boss. Overall, this is probably a bad matchup for us. We can go really wide. I don't know. We have the Chain Whirlers are awesome. Daredevil is just a 2-1 first strike blocker. Like, should I be taking it out? Or is that good enough to keep in? I did like the Karn there. What do y'all think is my worst card here? It's probably Banefire. It costs like a lot of mana to kill things. Like we're bringing in the other Lava Coils and the Cannonade, so that's a lot. Do I trim Treasure Map, Karn, Daredevil? Get rid of one map, one Daredevil, and one Karn? No. Another map? Yeah, Karn's basically only going to be good after we stabilize, actually. I'm just going to take out Karn. Actually, I think I would rather have Treasure Map than Karn. Map is kind of more important in our deck with having the Krasises. It not only makes like Krasis large and everything, but also really helps us fix our mana for Krasis. So it's kind of hard doing the Krasis thing without the maps. It's good at finding more Chain Whirlers and Cannonades. They don't usually do the whole haste thing, right? Let's get this treasure map going. Dawn of Hope. Perfect. Yeah. Oh yeah, I could change the avatar here for the mono red deck. We're not really too much of a Karn deck. We got, I guess we got two Karns. Then probably want like some red avatar. Dawn of Hope's really annoying. I'm glad we have the treasure map. Give us more card advantage to help deal with it. Oh, right. Now they flip landing. I guess they were already... Flipping landing's really not that big a deal. Flipping landing is really not that big a deal when they already have Dawn of Hope. Just basically gets them a land. Problem is, like, these lifelink triggers. Those ones. That's kind of a problem. Do I have any ways to deal with enchantments in my deck? Like, I do in the sideboard the Cinder Vines that I could bring in here. I don't think I do in the main deck. This Chain Whirler card's pretty good. Come on, Krasis. And Krasis. Not sure if Mardu Aristocrats will be a viable deck after War releases. I'm kind of thinking... No. By not no as in like not viable at all, but like not that good of a deck, I guess that's what I mean. I like there seems to be a whole lot of really powerful cards, but not very many for that deck. Like it does get a little bit of upgrades. 2, 3, 4, 5. Game's not over yet. Yeah, it's not we just win. They could, you know, they need to draw another tribunal, another removal spell, but if they don't find a removal spell, this Hellkite will certainly win. I don't want them to be able to draw two. Alright, well, I guess they get to draw two. Yeah, the Hellkite will beat Dawn of Hope. If it sticks. That's how you sound. This Arch of Araska has been really good for us. Okay, I'm trying to play. Activate. Activate. Three mana still. Gotta take out the lifelinkers so they don't draw from Donafoe. It's the most important.
I am proud to fight by your side.
Yeah, this Hellkite has been like a perfect draw. It has been so good for us. So much better than what a Siege Gang Commander would have been.
An option.
All right, then. So they would activate it at end step, and then I would activate Hellkite at end step to deal one damage to that, one damage to a Johnny. All right, 1-1 for mono red Krasis. We didn't even get to Krasis, but Hellkite just took over the Dawn of Hope. That was a good game. GG's. Ugh. Oh, I didn't change our avatar from Vanifar. Didn't get a more red avatar. This deck does look crazy, but it's good. It's a good deck. I don't know what I'm actually like upkeep scrying for. I think I'm just going to be drawing here. It's Grixis. Grixis. Yeah, I'm just going to draw a card. What do we draw? All right, so we know we definitely need land now. Preferably a green source land. Definitely looks like they're shocking in for a counterspell here. Might as well just not play a spell and just have these treasure maps start going crazy. Could have been shocking in for Bedevil as well, but likely Sinister Sabotage or Ionize. Glad. I'm glad our opponent did not have Hostage Taker there. Like these clean sleeves. Yeah, we're just simply mono red over here. Woo! Ditching Eldest Reborn? Gosh, that card is good. I'm really glad they ditched that card. Yeah, we're gonna be taking a stream where we talk about all the cards from War of the Spark. We'll be doing set review kind of stuff. We got another Scry. I mean, I would like a land drop, but so right now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This would be land number 7. Drops are good. Wish we had a Field of Ruin in here. Yeah, huge Banefire is a good plan. That's a good plan. Plan right now is just to keep expanding my mana base and draw a lot of cards with Arch of Araska and stuff.
Here be monsters.
That's a good card.
No fire, no steel.
I want to flip the treasure map, the treasure cove. Use one treasure here to get Phoenix in play also. Well, they're tapped out. Get a good battlefield position here. Yeah, our Arch of Araska has certainly been getting us good value this league. So they have like all the cards they could ever want in hand. And Daredevil Eldest Reborn? Is that a thing? No respect. No respect. Yeah, no, I know I can't actually Daredevil the Eldest Reborn. trying to bluff the opponent here with this attack. They've seen us discard a couple of shocks. I was hoping to have them be worried about shock. Yeah, I just played this bad. I should just play the Krasis for 8 first. All right, this turn I got way too cute there that turn. Yeah, got way too cute. Should just do this first. Yeah, like this should have been my first play. Get the counter spell out. And then coil the bolus. And then they're at 8 and I still have the Daredevil in play. Huh. Well, I just got to use a shock. This is a mean deck. Yeah, this deck is mean. The Wrathing only destroys creatures CMC 3 or less. These are both CMC 4. Chain Whirler. I don't really want. So I wanted to kind of wait on drawing these cards. I guess Chain Whirler would be fine. Kind of want to wait on drawing these because, you know, like they're a Thought Erasure deck. I don't really like putting cards in my hand. Yeah, we have one Banefire in the deck somewhere.
I do not feel pain.
That was Lightning Strike over here? Yeah, we can take up. You know, any Lightning Strike?
I'll make use of that laser.
So if I Krasis, we're drawing 5. We have to discard 2. Just doable. Said I'll just play the Chain Whirler though and activate Arch of Araska. Draw 3 with Krasis right now. I could just play a 6/6 Krasis. Is that bad? Not that bad. Or just draw a card with Arch of Araska and don't use my Krasis. I guess I don't know. Maybe I should just be playing the Krasis here to get it out of my hand because of Thought Erasure. It's all the shocks, right? Ugh. At least it's not us drawing the Banefire. You know, like, it could have played Krasis, we draw Banefire from Krasis, they get rid of Banefire kind of thing. Yeah, went a little laggy there. Hopefully it clears up now. Longer games, I think I've kind of noticed, longer games whenever I start looking at graveyards, I think that's kind of the thing that is the problem. Oh, we're not at end step. What am I doing here? Okay. Yep, we'll just Thought Erasure right back. I could have Karn make a Karn struct. We'll take up.
Good choice.
Only have two other mana. After activating Arch. Where's this Banefire at? We got 28 cards left. It's gotta be in here somewhere. I'll just wait. I just basically don't want to activate Arch, find Banefire, they Thought Erasure it, kind of thing. We'd still have 4 mana, so we'd still be able, like, if we draw another Phoenix or a Karn, we'd be able to play it, or a Chain Whirler. Like, we'd be able to play good cards, and we do have a lot of Chain Whirlers, Karns, and Phoenixes left. 6 total, to be exact, out of those. But yeah, if we drew something bigger... they'd be able to Thought Erasure it away. All right, we're at 26. So next turn they get Bolas back, have the mana to flip Bolas immediately. War should be... on
you're
arena on the
fuel
25th.
For the fires of
no fire, no steel.
Oh man, it's getting a little laggy here. Come on. Just let me discard my card. There we go. Alright, so Jellyfish Hydra Beast. If I spend 5, we still have 6 mana. So we can play Krasis for 4. Draw 2 with this Krasis.
That tickled.
Is that what I want to do? Yes. All right, we're down to 21 cards. And we know the bottom two are not Banefire, so we're at 19 cards left. We're looking for this Banefire. All right, that makes sense. That's probably a good play for the opponent. Upkeep stop.
No fire, no steel.
I was just thinking of Bolas. But I guess I guess Krasis makes a lot of sense too. 3, 6, 8. Put them up to 15. Ooh, kept 2 mana. That's perfect. I would not have had lethal with like activating map and finding Banefire, but now I do. They would have spent that other 2, I would not. So can we find the Banefire? Bottom. Whew! And now it's 14, right? 3, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, they didn't use that other little bit there. Thank you. Thank you for not gaining that extra 2 life, opponent, or that extra 1 life, opponent. Oh, Moment of Craving would have been really bad. Oh, I would have hated Moment of Craving. I would have been sad. Oh, Craving would have been bad. Gives us 60 right here. This mono red deck's good. Yeah, this is a good deck. Yeah, we can have expansion for their discards or like a larger explosion. Cindervines, we saw them have, you know, multiple Eldest Reborns as Kanta. I think I just want 2 Cindervines. Get a Lightning Strike in here. Gotta have enough answers for Thief of Sanity. And having removal spells for Hostage Taker ain't bad either. This gives me 5 2-mana removal spells for Thief. Plus Bolas also. I guess that's really not that much. Maybe I just don't play Cindervines. I have the Banefires, though, that can kill Thief also. Well, yeah, I'm going to just go with this. We'll see game 3 if we want Cindervine or not. I kind of like being a little more defensive here on the draw of like trying to stop their early creatures kind of thing. All right, good hand. We got the treasure map, got the answer to a Thief of Sanity immediately. Hey, Daft Square. Yeah, we're not playing Mono Red. We're playing Mono Red Krasis. That's different than Mono Red. So for the record, Lightning Strike could have been Cindervines, not either of these. So we wouldn't just have had like a Cindervines in hand. It would be a Lightning Strike would be that. No land drop? Dang. What's up, Hawkeye? Yep, I feel you. Ditching duress.
Here, no fire, no
Hellkite or Lava Coil? I think Hellkite. Yeah, give me that land. Definitely relying on Krasis here. That's 5 loyalty, right? Okay.
Make all sail for high and dry.
Problem with going with the Hellkite there is Hellkite doesn't actually kill Angrath, and Angrath just picks our hand apart even more. Just using the Banefire to kill that thing. Last card's a counterspell. Please don't find removal here. Please, kind opponent. Ugh, they just kept that card. That's bad. That was a perfect time to have the one cast down out of all the cards. That was the perfect time to have it. This could be the Cinder Vines. Do I kill Thief or Angrath? I guess I kill Thief.
Run. A chase. Dope your crew for my freedom.
Yeah, I guess I kill Thief. Definitely glad this is Lightning Strike and not Cinder Vines. That's for sure. No, my Arch of Araska. Could get this Lightning Strike countered, but we're a little behind here. I like the versatility of it. Maybe I should just be killing the Thief.
No fire, no steel.
I kept that card on top again.
Our actions move. I'll make use of that later.
So I kind of need to be able to double block the Hellkite. I don't know. Killing Thief or Angrath is tough. There's definitely reasons to kill either one. We're like right now with emptying the hand, which I thought I was going to be emptying the hand, the Angrath tick up for this turn doesn't do a whole lot for this turn. Angrath is awesome, though. Stealing that Krasis the first time was great. They could steal another Krasis this next turn, potentially. One of their cards in hand they like, they kept with Azcanta last turn, but didn't play it. They played the Hellkite instead. So they definitely like one of their cards. The other card over here that's ours could just be a land. How big are we making this Krasis?
The time has come.
One, two, three, four. Making this thing an 8/8. I need to draw. Need to draw Coil. Not a coil. This game's over. I had to draw Coil for Bolas. Oh my gosh, they're blocking with Bolas. Oh, it's still over either way. Yeah, it's just over either way. Right, because Angrath still just steals the Krasis either way. If they don't block, they can still just like flip Bolas, get Angrath back, and kill the Krasis. I needed exactly Lava Coil to get rid of the Bolas. I think I like my deck here. I think I like the Lightning Strikes. Yeah. And I do think I like War Boss, right? Maybe not. Maybe War Boss just gets outclassed. Should I have two Cinder Vines and a Lightning Strike instead of the three War Bosses? No, I like War Boss on the play. They use removal on War Boss, they don't get removal on other things. That's a pretty good game there. Yeah, that's why I like that I'm playing the Lightning Strikes instead of Cinder Vines to make sure we have enough removal for Thief, but I'd like to draw a treasure map here, please. We were looking okay when they had Azcanta and Thief and no cards in hand, and we were playing Phoenix, and we had Treasure Map going. We were looking okay, but we had the double... Or no, we were playing the Krasises, sorry. We were playing the double Krasises, but they drew those the removal spells for the Krasises with their top card was a cast down, and then the next card was Angrath. And the Angrath in particular really got us. Vivian's too hard to cast in this deck, as you can just tell from how it looks right now. Vivian's just too hard to cast in this one. So yeah, I definitely like Karn more than Vivian here. Go, Owls, go.
You're just fuel for the fires of your crew from
right, well, that's not a bad trade for us. Phoenix.
A fair price.
Phoenix trading for Angrath and a cast down. And because of Archer Roscoe, I do want to just keep hitting land drops. Could keep the land in hand, thinking about, like, okay, if they play Bolas, I want to discard the land and have these spells still. But because of Archer Roscoe, playing a bunch of lands is the way to go. Man, I wish this was Cindervines now. Plus, we didn't have any other green sources out, so getting the green source in play, that's probably a smart idea as well. What's our opponent shocking there for? Like, they don't have Contempt mana available. What are you shocking there for, opponent? Ah, right, Insight. Yeah, we saw Insight game one. So Lightning Strikes could go upstairs and put a quick clock on our opponent. Yep, y'all called it. The Insights. I need three more permanents before we have Arch of Araska turned on. That's a lot of permanents. Taking a strike. Yeah, they are definitely worried about this Phoenix. But they're going to have Azcanta transformed. All right, two more permanents for Arch Verazka. No, I don't think... No, just using all the strikes in response. Then we just discard the Lava Coil. Then they just, like... kill the like we're just too all in on the Phoenix at that point. We need like their creatures like Thief and Nicol Bolas and things like that are pretty valuable, and we need to make sure we still have interaction. We're not blanking their Thought Erasure by just firing off strikes. Okay, good card. Nice, it resolved. One permanent away from Arch of Araska. This game, though, with our opponent having Azcanta, Eldest Reborn, you know, like, this game, it certainly would have been nice to have... would have been nice to have Cindervines this game. So there's one more Lightning Strike in the deck, right? Yeah, I'm playing three. We also have the three Banefires. Ooh, I forgot about Banefire. We just find a Banefire here. Guess we are just emptying the hand. Bane Fire. You're not bad, Karn. You do get contempted. Yeah, probably just bottom. Bane Fire. Dang. Basically the same game we had the first time. Yep, Angrath would have just cleared our hand.
Here be mono fire.
I'll just activate Archer Roscoe at end step. So we got three Banefires in here out of, that's 43, but we know the bottom three, so three out of 40. Drawing a couple cards a turn. Well, huh. Krasis does just get stolen by Angrath. Yeah, we played Mono Black earlier. If you want to, the league was definitely good. If you want to check it out, it's up on the YouTube channel right now, right there. Just put the link in the chat. YouTube.com/ToddStevensMTG. I definitely talked about things I'd want to, things I'd like to change about the Mono Black aggro deck. You know, we're trying it out. Definitely hoping to hit like the other lightning strike here, where the opponent like taps out for contempting the Krasis, and then we would have been able to use the two treasures to strike, but it didn't happen. What do I have over here? Thought Erasure, Duress, nothing that kills Angrath. All right, so we're at 3 out of 34 cards. Top 34 cards, 3 of them are Banefires.
No fire, no steel.
See what we got going on over here. Thank you. Oh, right. I'm going to just contempt this thing now. Crap. It's going to use, like, two treasures. I was planning on just cast downing the Hydro Krasis, but honestly, I should probably just contempt the Angrath, shouldn't I? Crap, I shouldn't have used that Lava Coil. I should have just saved that Lava Coil in hand and then just contempted this thing. So 32 cards. Looking for these Banefires. Really? That's what you sound like. Alright, I like that.
Your crew from
that means it's a lot farther from like Angrath Ultimating.
A fair price.
Which Angrath Ultimating is like the fast way for us to get down. Fast way for us to lose. Draw card. One, two, three, four, five. If we draw a card, we will have... If we draw Banefire, we have Banefire for six. Drawing the card is good against everything except for... Like, if we draw Banefire, it's a bad draw. If we draw anything else, it's good. Basically. No, I guess not anything else. We draw a removal spell. It's not really that good either. Oh, wait. So we're at 30 cards now.
No fire, no steel.
3 out of 30, so 10%. We have a 10% chance now. And then, of course, we're drawing at end step and then also drawing for turn. Banefire. All right, that's not bad. All right, Angrath out of here.
Make all sail for high and dry.
I'll crack Treasure Cove at end step. So we're looking at 3 out of 28 now. Because we know the bottom three cards are trash. So three out of the 28 are Banefires. Oh, man. I want to draw a whole lot of cards, but then drawing a whole lot of cards does turn on the opponent's Thought Erasure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, we do have three Banefires, though. So we could hit two of them. Who knows? Or we hit zero, and we just dig another five. All right, well, we got two. That could be bad. If our opponent finds another Thought Erasure. It could certainly be bad that we found two. I kind of wanted to draw zero, honestly. Like, I was hoping to draw zero Banefires there, to be honest. I was hoping just to draw five and no Banefires. Game's not over. Our opponent could have, you know, they already have one discard spell. They could just have another one out of these six cards here. I honestly don't really like where we're at, that we found two Banefires. Like, y'all are saying GG, but I don't think this is GG at all. They just need one more discard spell. And now that they know they need a discard spell, they can use the Azcanta to find one also. I wanted to draw zero Banefires there. The drawing two was bad. So now we only have one left in 20 cards. So now we're down to a 5%er. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
I will defend my ally.
No Banefire, no Banefire, no Banefire. Okay, good. Because if we would have found Banefire, they just choose the other card, give us the other card, kill the Karn. So now we're down to 17. And then we're going to be drawing a card end step with the Arch of Vraska also.
Do not pity me.
I don't know. Karnstruck just makes a 1-1. And, like, is that 1-1 really valuable? Just not too likely that we hit the Banefire. We talked about there's only one left and there's, you know, a whole lot of cards. Hmm. Don't even know if I want to cast Krasis. Oh. No, I think the answer is no. Well, dang it. I should have scryed with the treasure map first. I could have, like, Krasis for two and draw that war boss or whatever and just have another war boss out. Man, this has been such a long match. I do not regret not double lightning striking way, way, way back in this game. I don't regret that. I still don't think that was the correct thing to do. Yeah, I'm here every day for 7 hours, from 3 to 10 Eastern is whenever I stream. So this is my full-time job here. So I really do appreciate everybody being here watching and supporting and all subscribers and everything. So yeah, we're at the end of towards the end of the stream here today. Over 7 hours right now. We're only in match number 2 for Mono Red Krasis, and I like our chances. So there's one more Banefire in the next 12 cards. All right, starting to not like my chances as much. One out of 12 is like around 8%. Basically, it's like 12 times what is 100? 12 times 8 is 96, so it's a little higher. It's like 8.25%-ish.
Never seen water burn, no fire.
But we're seeing,
no
like,
steel.
You know, we're going to be seeing a bunch of cards before our next turn.
Fire and fury.
I'll just hit that Angrath, make it harder for Angrath to transform, or sorry, to ultimate. Sorry. All right, Bolas transforming.
The multiverse is at my disposal. The dead shall serve me.
Okay. Yeah, so we're at like 8.25%. All right, now it's 1 out of 11, so that's like 9%-ish. Okay. Now it's 1 out of 10, so we're at like 10%. So we got like an 8% and a 9% and a 10% all there. All right, and now it's 1 out of 9. So now it's like 11%. So we get like 4 looks at it here. Okay. So now it's 12%. Like 1 out of 8. Well, let's see, what if I draw a card with Arch, I'm looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana left. So I would be able to Banefire for 8. Yeah, yep. Thief milling us. Could be game. Because they'd be able to look at 3 cards for the Banefire. I only have 5 cards left after that. We really need to see it in one of those 4 cards. You know, we had 4 hits there. It was really that one Krasis of mine doing that Krasis for 5. Hitting double Banefire, that was really, really rough. And then couldn't find another one. They cannot steal Phoenix, no. They can have... Yeah, they can kill Phoenix with Bolas. Alright, they're drawing.
My genius is unmatched.
I like seeing that. You know, because if they would have just minus 3'd the...
No fire, no steel.
The Bolas, that would have been trouble. I guess they, with Azcanta, they know the exact order of their library and everything by now, so they just knew they were drawing a Hostage Taker. I don't have any instant speed removal. And it doesn't matter whether I draw now or wait till later. I mean, so I might as well just wait because of discard spells. It's not like it's a better percentage chance that it's the top, one of the, like, the top card than the fourth card. There's no percent chance different there, so please whiff. Please whiff. All right, that was land, land, and something else. So now there's like 6 unknown cards. Those 5 we don't know about, plus this one here. There's 6 unknown cards, and one of them's a Banefire. Oh. Oh. I forgot we have Explosion in here too. I forgot about that. We have that card too. Well, that'll do it. Just throw this up there for 9. Because we know that's not a counterspell. We know our card's not a counterspell. Let's draw a card first and let's just see what we have. Because I can still do this for 9, right? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. So let's just draw a card, see if we would hit the Banefire also. That's not Banefire. We know our opponent does not have Moment of Graving. So the Banefire is either this card or that card that my opponent has. It's one of those two. All right, make them mill out. It was either the very last card or the card they stole. Man, that was a long, tough match. We got three more to play. Yeah, what a game there. We have had some crazy games today. Some of the best games that I've played in months had today. I'm sure, like, we have a lot more viewers in here than what we had earlier. The Selesnya control deck that I played earlier. Game number two of the very first match, which I'm going to put the YouTube link here in the chat if you want to check it out later. The second game of the first match was absolutely insane. One of the longest, best games that I've ever played. Even better than that game. Yes, I would still cast that Krasis again in hindsight, yes. Yeah, you can find the mono black aggro list here under decks. That one is also on my YouTube channel though, and I talked about afterwards on the YouTube channel like some things that I want to try changing with it. That I'm gonna play mono black aggro again tomorrow. I don't know if this is one of my favorite deck donations, but this was certainly a good one. But yeah, that game two with the Selesnya control that I'm talking about, I had no answers to my opponent playing turn... They were on the play and played turn four... Actually, I think I was on the play. Whatever. But they played turn four at Johnny. You know, the mono-white at Johnny. And I had absolutely no answers to it at all in the entire deck. And so it just sat there. And it ultimated. And... it ultimated again. They just ticked up enough to ultimate to make three, you know, kitty cats a turn, and then ultimated again. And I'm playing like a zero creature deck, by the way. It was ridiculous. And I had two Settle the Wreckages, and I stayed alive long enough, because I just had Dawn of Hope, and I just had Dawn of Hope fighting off the tokens. Stayed alive long enough to finally get a Vivian and ultimate the Vivian. And then after the ultimate Vivians, then my Dawn of Hope tokens were bigger than their cats. Anyway, Jade Vault, thank you so much for that Twitch Prime sub, Jade Vault. You are amazing. Thank you so much. But yeah, that was an incredible game. That was game two, match number one, if you want to check that out. With that Selesnya control that I just linked in for the YouTube there. Guess I'm drawing here. I think I need to make sure that I can pay for a... So I think I want a coil. I guess I need a chain whirler. So I can pay for Spell Pierce with coil right now. The problem with using the coil now, though, I guess, is if they just like play like Tempest Gens, they don't have removal for that. I guess I need to use chain whirler. Just turns on Essence Capture. It's fine. Now next turn I get to coil plus play a big Krasis. I can do both of those next turn. After flipping this map. Can I get that Chain Whirler back? No, I think our mono blue matchup's probably pretty good. Our hand's been kind of awkward here, and I should have stopped on my end step and cast shock. On my end step with the trickster, I should have set a stop there. I just didn't get there in time to do that. Well, coil doesn't make a ton of sense for us now. So let's just play a Krasis for four. One, two, three, four, five. Can't even kill this Terramander, this Storm Tamer. That was annoying. Hey, RDM. Wow. Things I did not expect. Are you a wizard? No, you're not a wizard. Vekasis getting that Harry's Razor. And Sway, finally able to drop in and share my 4 month. Thank you so much, Sway. I guess I'm just gonna go Daredevil Opt. All right, so let's see. Sub battle countdown down to 35. And we're getting that Razor. We are at 36 out of 40 for another 12-hour sub through Harry's. I can't block that thing. Next turn I can play Karn, make a Karn struck and block that. So if y'all don't know about this Harry's deal, we only need 4 more people to sign up also that I'm going to be doing a 12-hour stream. But basically, you have a really, really good deal with Harry's right now. You can get their starter set, which is their razor handle, their 5-blade German-engineered razor, the travel cover, and a container of shaving cream mailed to your house with free shipping for only $3. You can't really get cheaper products than that, and it's a really quality product as well for just a wonderful price. It's only $3. How it works is go through my referral link that I'm going to go ahead and put in the chat here, but it's also down below in the info panel. Sign up for their starter set, get the subscription. The starter set's usually $13. Get the subscription, which will take out $5 and it'll make it $8. Now the subscription is cancelable anytime, so you don't need to worry about further purchases if you don't want it. And then also use that coupon code ToddStevensMTG and you get $5 off again. And it drops it down all the way down to only $3 after that. I want to play this Hellkite. Now let's do this. Yeah, you ordered two of the razors. Definitely, yeah, it is a no-brainer for the $3 starter set. Really is. Even if you don't like to shave, you got a friend that you want to get a present for, that's perfect, you know. Just $3 shipping to your house. You just can't get products. You can't just get anything for cheaper than that, really, right? Like, I don't know how the Rangers are doing tonight. I think I want to keep the... Alright, so if I keep Lightning Strike up, this can only be a... No, that can only... I don't need to keep Lightning Strike up. We'll just cast Opt. I don't think I'm supposed to say how much I make off of selling the razors. I don't think I'm supposed to say that. But... Correct. So the trial's 8, not 3. So... Sign up for the subscription for the trial also. The subscription knocks off $5, and then use my coupon code ToddStevensMTG to get the other $5 off. So that's how you turn it into $3. So it's usually $13. Do both of those things. You can cancel the subscription at any time. If you want to cancel the subscription right after, you can. Yeah, but... I need this Hellkite to resolve. How do I get Hellkite to resolve? Yeah, I will say I do get more than $3 for each one of those that y'all purchase, so. Don't think I'm supposed to say the exact amount, but yeah, I do make more than the $3, so it's just such a no-brainer. If you want to help support the stream, it's a good, easy way to do it. Get yourself a razor. Well... Let's give it a try. Ah, dive down. Yes, Solman. All right, so we can't block this since now they get to draw a whole lot of cards. Less chance that our Hellkite's going to resolve now because they... Let's see if they stack them in the correct order. Nope, so they do the... Oh, they did it the correct order. All right, so they draw a card. There. Oh, yeah, it's US, Canada, and UK is that deal. That specific deal with the free shipping and everything is US, Canada, UK. I believe that's what it is. I can't declare a block. This cannot... I can't... Green creatures can't block Surge Mare, so I can't block that. Okay, we get to resolve this. That's good news. And the last thing with the Harry's Razor, if you don't have your ad block on for that site, we'll get that notification that pops up like we did a little bit ago. If you have your ad blocker on, we don't get the notification. It's a close game. We'll see if we get to actually untap. And Surge Mare just perfectly... Perfect numbers there with the three toughness still. Alright, down to one. Come on, another one of those? That Chain Whirler be able to block the Surge Mare. Man, Chain Whirler would have been a good creature to block. Man, that if those two were just reversed, that would have been good. I don't know, it's something to do with the software that in order for them to send the projection onto the channel and everything, I guess it goes, like, you need, like, the ad block not on. And so, like, that's why there should be, like, a notice that says that at, like, the beginning that's, like, please turn off your ad block for the site so this goes through kind of thing. I guess we're cannonading. Man, those O5s. Yeah, that game was over. I can't block that O5, but they get to just pump it. My opponent had lethal I couldn't do anything about there. That horse killed me. Let's get expansion so we can counter their counterspell. Hey Red West, thank you so much for the subscription. I'm cutting Treasure Map. No, Treasure Map was actually good there, that game. I gotta cut stuff, though. I don't need Daredevil. Ah! Dang it. Sorry. I didn't sideboard in time. I should cut Daredevil. That should be my cut. No, I don't want Cinder Vines, you know, even though, you know, Cinder Vines can blow up the enchantment, but that's not something that I really want. I think I wanted to cut Daredevil and have all the removal spells, like maybe even play Banefire here and just get rid of Daredevil. Maybe just the two Daredevil for the, yeah, the cut the two Daredevil for the two Lava Coil and two Fiery Cannonade, actually, just that. That's what I wanted to do here. Yeah, so I just wear a shirt and tie because this is how I like to present myself. I'm pretty comfortable in a shirt and a tie, and I like how I look in it, and that's why I like to dress like this. Crazy how good that card's looked. That card was awesome, game one. So it's so good against red removal. You know, five toughness, so much. Sorry, he's... There you go, there's Hawkeye, he's back there. Yeah, see, okay, I just don't drink anymore, so. Ugh. Why does that thing have to have the Curious Obsession? Alright, well. As long as they don't have the Essence Capture, we can resolve Phoenix. And Phoenix does a great job of blocking Surge Mare. So just hoping no Essence Capture here. Yeah, this horse. This horse is getting us. Oh, come on. Well, there's just nothing I can do here. Surge Mare is so good against red. Yeah, right? We're a red deck that has lost to the can't be blocked by green creatures horse. Their worst card in hand is Dive Down. That's saying something. Yeah, all they need is one more counterspell, then it's game. Well, keeping the three mana up, I think that Phoenix certainly gets countered there. So I will... Hey, that worked!
I am Karn.
Yeah, you're Karn, you know.
Some solutions must be built.
I guess, sure they want to trickster this? All right, that's fine. We'll have the blocker for next turn. Oh, it loses the ability, so it's just a 0/0. No! Yeah, I don't mind mono blue.
There are greater battles to fight.
The Curious Obsession is the annoying thing. I was hoping they were going to counter this. But now I'm kind of priced into just doing this. They gotta run out of counterspells for creatures here pretty soon, right? Right? Hmm. Hey, what's up, Eddie? Definitely have more dive downs if they were discarding a dive down earlier. And if they're making that attack with Trickster, that's definitely saying, hey, I have a dive down. Yay, Phoenix resolves. Ooh. Even better than Phoenix. But I think I'd rather have Phoenix resolve, though. Phoenix resolve first. Because I want Phoenix to be able to block Surge Mare, is basically what I'm saying. And I'll waste this mana for my opponent instead of just letting them cast the dive down right now. I'll cast the Lightning Strike on their turn. So make them use that one mana on dive down on their turn. I guess I let them draw and then just draw instead of draw plus loot. Yeah, draw is better than draw than loot. Alright, does Hellkite resolve now? Ooh. Hellkite resolve. Yuck. I think we may be too far behind though. But we'll see. Four? Alright, so this costs four. Terramander does, that is. Hey, what's up, Boot? Oh, sorry, Eddie asks, when you play both Arena and Paper Magic, do you still find yourself making misplays that you haven't played Paper Magic in 2 months but have been playing a lot of Arena? Not really. Like, so you're saying, like, when you've just been playing, like, Arena for a couple months and then you play in Paper, do you make... I assume this is how the question is worded. Then do you make certain mistakes in Paper that you wouldn't have because you're used to playing on Arena? I think that's what that statement is. And I would say that I'm making this block. Basically, Paper is a lot slower than Arena, and you usually have more time to, like, think out your decisions. You know, you have all, like, the shuffling and everything, like, your opponent's turns. Like, it's usually just a slower game, and so you usually, like, I wouldn't be too worried about making more mistakes in Paper. I make a lot less mistakes in Paper. I make a lot more mistakes on Arena in general, because play so much faster. Let's see. Is there any way they pump this once? So they have to pump that twice. So make a block like this, where one of those is dead. Oh. Or I could just try to just kill the Tempest Djinn and block like this, but I'm just never getting rid of that Surge Mare. Yeah, this is my block. All right, Fiery Cannon. I don't even know what that really does for us. All these things have 5 toughness and 7 toughness. Ugh. So much toughness. I guess I need to block the 6-5 with the Hellkite and not the 2-7. I liked blocking the Terramander, but I think I need to block the 6-5 and the Terramander. Alright, 2-1. Wow, this has been a long league, just a long night. Yeah, there you go, Dog Breath. Yep, right there. Those are 2 sponsors to the stream. MVMT is pronounced Movement. They sell watches and sunglasses, and by using my referral link you get 15% off. And Quip makes amazing toothbrushes. I can't recommend Quip nearly enough. If you, and like my referral link gets you a refill free there. If you make a purchase with either Quip or Movement, with those two, you get a free donation deck. I don't think we were really throwing that game. I don't know, that was just... I just couldn't beat that horse. Alright, well that's a good card. I wanted that one anyway. Yeah, I couldn't beat that combination of that horse and then Curious Obsession. Really? Well, you're lucky I like drawing that card. It's the second time. Get this stop in there this time. That is true. I was, yeah, reading the chat and stuff, and I miss-sideboarded. That's fair. I'll give you that. All right, I'll give you that one. I expect my opponent to have lightning strikes, lava coil, stuff like that. So I think the Daredevil is a pretty good pickup here. Yeah, to be fair, it's not that I'm just tired, but I'm also just really hungry. I ate a very, very small lunch today, and so I've not had very much food, and it's 11 p.m., and, you know, I wake up at, like, 8 a.m. every morning. Hawkeye wakes me up, and I've had just a very small sandwich, so. Another way I'm fighting through this. Oh, no. No. I need to turn on my Daredevil. Don't have your Daredevil turned on. Well, we're in our last league. I'm gonna make some food after this. I'll be fine. Nubja, getting that gifted sub from the craziest of pyros, Crazy Pyro. Thank you very much for that gifted sub. All right, so if I keep this, we're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, let's keep this. I could spend both treasures and make the Krasis an 8-8. And then I don't have to worry about collision. because collision kills the 6/6 Krasis. But I don't think that's worth it. Or just doubling up on the strikes. Haven't decided exactly what's for dinner yet. I have a good amount of leftovers. Well, I didn't go bad last time. Let's just do this again. See, we're both this like green red deck with like the same kind of cards, but we got Krasis and treasure map. Now we can whirl some chains at this pirate. Everybody knows pirates don't like chains being whirled. All right, coils in. Karn out. Hellkite out. I could see Hellkite out, honestly. Their removal. Banefire out. And I could see a shock out. Shock doesn't actually kill hardly anything in their deck. Yeah, let's take a shock out. Maybe another Karn in, another shock out. Nah, keep it like this. Explosion is definitely one I could see bringing in here too. That's probably the one card in my sideboard that I wish I had in my deck right now was Explosion. So I don't want to see Growth Chamber Guardian right about now. Do not want to see Growth Chamber Guardian. All right, that's fine. Oh, I should put Simic Midrange up on the YouTube channel. Harder to win on the draw. We'll be on the play for game three, though. Could have used that land. Daredeviling their lightning strike would have been great here, because Daredevil checks the Harpooner. Would have been easier on the play. All right, on the play. All right, Civic Midrange, almost ready. So I am going to have to shock next turn, but I want to be able to lightning strike their 2-drop here and then untap and play Chain Whirler. That's like the worst 2-drop, though. Oh well. Basically, I don't want them to So I don't want to just, like, not do that. And then I shock in for Chain Whirler here. They Lightning Strike my Chain Whirler, attack me for three, you know, and so on. And then I'm just kind of always behind. Midrange. All right, that one's up now. Maybe I should have just been attacking the last turn. Problem is, like, if I would have attacked with Phoenix last turn, that would have just put the opponent down to, like, 14. Or whatever, 14, 15. And then if they had, like, Collision, Colossus that kills the Hellkite. Then they hit me down to 10 with the Spellbreaker, and I'm in a lot of trouble at that point. So I actually like not attacking. Three and one. Ooh, Kefnet's out? I haven't seen Kefnet. All right, 4UU for a 4/5 flying. It's a zombie. Oh, they're all of them are zombies. Ooh, I could get these for my zombie deck. Ooh, we can play green-black zombies with Molder Hulk and stuff, and Liliana. All right, anyway, what does this card do? So 4/5 flyer for four. That's good stats. You may reveal the first card you draw each turn as you draw it, whenever you reveal an instant or sorcery card. Copy that card, and you may cast the copy. Okay, the copy costs two less to cast. All right, so you still have to pay the mana, but you can spend two less. And then yeah, whenever it dies. That's a pretty good card. Man, these zombie gods are good. Like, this cycle looks really good. What's our opponent doing over there? Unclear. Are they playing my Simic midrange deck? Ooh, maybe they're playing Simic midrange. Yeah, maybe they're playing the midrange deck we just played right before this. Ow. So if the Chain Whirler hits them one more time next turn, we do have 10 points of burn here in our hand. I don't know. Maybe I just shouldn't even do that. Maybe I should just kept the 10 points of burn, actually. Haste. Wait, this could be quasi-duplet ooze. Yeah, I'm liking Mono Red Krasis. I think this deck is legit. Yeah, I definitely think this is a legit deck. No Wild Growth Walker, please. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, this is the deck from yesterday. Yeah, we're playing it again today. I guess Daredevils. I guess, yeah, we're just not doing anything with Daredevils. Dog Breath! Getting that Quip Toothbrush. Gotta dog breath with the toothbrush. Yeah, we gotta fix that dog breath. Matt gets some hype boats in the chat. Thank you so much, dog breath. And for getting that toothbrush, if you'd ever like a donation deck, no expiration. Anytime there's any deck you want me to play on stream through a league, you just let me know, send me a message. You get a free donation deck for signing up there. I guess Banefire. See that, like, I could get this other Karn in here. Actually, let's get a Cannonade. Yeah, actually, let's grab two Cannonades. Mana creatures, biogenic oozes, explore creatures, lots of things to Cannonade away. Hey, Phylax. Howdy, howdy. Ugh. No changes so far to the deck since, like, you know, played it yesterday. Still liking this 75, but, you know, we're only on, let's see, we played 6 matches yesterday. We went 5-1 and now 4 another. So this is match number 11 with the deck. I'm liking the main deck. I'm not sure, you know, I just don't know too much about sideboard if we need to change anything, but there hasn't been any, like, glaring hole or anything that I feel like we're missing or any change that needs to be made kind of thing so far. Play more Land of War Elves. Ugh, not that one, the Land of War Elf. No exclamation point. Or no, no, yeah, apostrophe. That's what I meant. Yeah, I like my opponent's deck. This is, yeah, this is quasi-duplet ooze. Woo! I love it. Oh, that is awesome. Don't get to play against my decks very often. So thank you, FearZim. Love it. Not even going to be mad if we lose. Hand it has been really good. You know, we had turn two Lava Coil, and then turn three Chain Whirler, turn four Phoenix, turn five Hellkite. You know, like, we're just curving out incredibly well here.
Let's see if you're worth it. That can't help you now.
All right, all right. You got me. Oh. I don't know about... Well, I guess they just weren't blocking. Yeah, they missed land drops, too. Like, we curved out perfectly, and the opponent just missed land drops.
Most wounds can heal.
Sorry, Fearzim.
I'll be back, just like before.
Yeah, they just missed too many land drops. We had, a perfect hand. You know, we had the Lava Coil for the Wild Growth Walker, which was vital. And then, perfect hand. Chain Whirler, Phoenix, Hellkite, double Chain Whirler. Yeah, that was just an amazing hand. Sorry, Fearzim. Hey, love the quasi-dupla ooze. Sorry, I drew so well both of those games. Alright, we are on the final boss. We are 4-1. Let's get our final boss playlist up. Alright, getting in the zone. How are you liking quasi-dupla ooze there, Fearzim? All right, Espa Control. Well, this Lava Coil is a little dead. Okay, cool. It's working. Nice. Yeah, the new God cards are looking really good. That looks to be a really, really good cycle. That's going to be... Looks to be like it'll be a big part of Standard. Really know what I'm looking for. I'm not gonna ditch a Krasis, but I need land drops. We've been doing good against Esper Control. I mean, I think we're just 1-0. I think we just played it one time yesterday and we won. But we lost game one and we won games 2 and 3. Yeah, that's what happened last time. So we'll see, like, that's only one match, though. This is, you know, our opponent being on the play with triple Thought Erasure. That's kind of rough. We're going to try to Thought Erasure them back. Dang, I wish I would have grabbed that Chemist's Insight now. So I did want to grab the Chemist's Insight because otherwise they would just cast it in response. Are they going to Cleansing Nova away my two treasures? May not be a bad play. Let's draw our card first. Ugh. Why do we have to draw both of our lava coils? We have two in the deck. And, you know, like, they're just dead in this matchup. We had to draw both of them. Leonidas Gun. With the Twitch Prime sub for 13 lucky months in a row. We know that brings the hypo. Thank you so much. Our sub battle countdown all the way down to 32. After 32 more subs and resubs, we'll be doing another day of sub battling. That was a lot of fun that previous time we did it. Ugh. No, I don't think Gruul Warriors would be too hard of a deck to pilot. Yeah, the boar seems really good. All of the God series seems pretty good. The set just feels really pushed. Like, a lot of these Planeswalkers look really good.
I will fight thee. How convenient. An excellent choice.
This game has not gone our way with us drawing these two lava coils and them having triple thought erasure, taking my poor Krasises. Yeah, it looks like War of the Spark's going to have a really big impact on the format. So many quality cards. Planeswalker stand out to me. Nicol Bolas, Chandra, Jace, Teferi, Domri. I don't really like Hellkite here. Do I want to play... Chain Whirler is not very good either. It's Chain Whirler and Hellkite. So do I want to play Lightning Strikes instead of Chain Whirlers? No, actually, wait. I went with... I don't remember what I did with this last card last time we played with Esper. I think I went with kept all the Chain Whirlers, and I think I might have played one Lightning Strike over this. One Lightning Strike for, like, Thief. And Hostage Taker and stuff. I'm going to get the Hellkite in here. What if they have Thief? We'll kill it with something. Haven't found out what yet, but we'll kill it with something. We have the Banefires that could kill it. We have Direfleet Daredevil that can get their removal spell to kill it. We have like Phoenix and Krasis and Hellkite that are all like bigger flyers that block it. Here comes another three Thought Erasures. All right, so if they take the Chain Whirler, okay, well. Never mind. I was like, do I just cast this Krasis for one? Like a 1/1? Blank a Thought Erasure? But nah, we just don't do that. Getting rid of that as Canton now so they don't get to do like the exploring part. They don't get like the trigger turn after turn. I I was trying to get the Krasis out of my hand because of Thought Erasure, because I thought it was kind of obvious that our opponent had a Thought Erasure. Okay. No. This is the problem with Banefire. Banefire is like only good on like turn 20. Looks like we're losing this one. The whole Cinder Vines destroy their Ascanta thing backfired with them having another Ascanta. Everything's kind of backfired.
You know what? I'm not done yet.
Okay, that is game over. We did not defeat the final boss. Esper control got us that time. Did not have a very good hand against Esper. You know, don't have like our treasure map, stuff like that. I don't know. I don't think that. So now we're 1-1 against Esper. You know, like I don't think that like. The matchup's horrible or anything, how both of those games were a slaughter. Opponent just had awesome hands, and mine were not. So that's all good. All good. So, really fun stream, though, tonight. So thanks, everybody, for being here. Mono Red Krasis still looked good. Still looked good overall with the 4-2. Nothing, you know, that's nothing to be ashamed of there. Haven't really found anything exactly to change yet. I think we'd still probably need a little bit more practice with the deck. Nothing like seeming super bad. Like maybe I should have two expansions and only one other Banefire and have a second expansion. Maybe I should have that. That could be something. Maybe not the Banefire in the main. I don't know. We'll get some more practice with it. But if you're watching this video later on YouTube, thanks for watching.